Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Fernando Schoffelbein, member of the Beirut Memorial Advisory Board, and I will be your master of ceremony for today's observance. Today, we as a community continue a tradition. It marks the 39th anniversary of October 23rd, 1983. Beirut Memorial Advisory Board, who with the City of Jacksonville, conducts this annual observance. At this location, with significant support of Marine Corps Installations East, Marine Corps Base Camp Lejeune, please rise for the invocation, which will be offered by Pastor Robert Williams of Tar Landing Baptist Church, followed by the presentations of the color and national anthem.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, our Holy God, you are the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You are the God that has created the heavens and the earth and all that is within them. Father, we thank you for many years ago creating and forming this great nation, the United States of America. We thank you for the protection that you have provided our great nation. Father, we thank you for all the service men and women who have served in years past, that are currently serving, and those that will serve in the future. We thank you for their continued sacrifice for our nation, for protecting us and keeping us safe. And Father, we thank you for the time we have together today to assemble. We thank you as we come together to remember those who have paid the ultimate price. They have given the ultimate sacrifice of their life so that we could be free, so that we could live here in America. Father, today we bless the memory of those servicemen and women who have given their life. We pray that as we honor them this day, that we will never forget that which they have done for us. That today's events will bring honor and glory to your name, that they would be a comfort to the families, that it would bring peace. Again, Father, we thank you that these men and women have given their lives for us. Your word tells us that no greater love hath anyone than to lay down his life for his friends. So we thank you for these. We thank you that you know what it is to sacrifice for us by sending your son, Jesus, for us. And it is in Jesus Christ's name that I pray these things. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. March on the colors.
Ready, face.
Thank you.
Please be seated. On Sunday morning, October 23rd, 1983, 39 years ago today, a violent bombing took place at the headquarters building of the United States Peacekeeping Force in Beirut, Lebanon. This event, plus subsequent actions in Beirut and Grenada, caused the deaths of 273 U.S. Marines, sailors, and soldiers. Most of these men were from Camp Lejeune and were friends and neighbors of the citizens of Jacksonville and Onslow County. Almost simultaneously, another bomb detonated in another section of Beirut, killing 58 members of the French peacekeeping force. This ceremony remembers the events of that day and honors those who lost their lives in the cause of peace. While today's observance focuses on the Americans who lost their lives, let us also honor those who were part of the French peacekeeping force. Today, representing the French military is Major Jeremy Crusette, French exchange officer for the 2nd Marine Division. Thank you, sir, for attending. And let us give grateful appreciation for the Italian forces who helped rescue our troops. Their national flags have been placed at the memorial for today's observance. Let us now honor our French and Italian colleagues with a moment of silence. Thank you. Our community has vowed to never forget the events of October 23rd, 1983. And that is why this observance has been held annually. Thank you for being part of renewing our pledge to never forget and for your participation in honor for those named on the wall behind me who lost their lives in the cause of peace. I would like to give a special welcome to the family members and the Beirut veterans who are attending. In addition to this ceremony, the Marine Corps League Detachment 262 will conduct their annual wreath-laying ceremony at the Beirut Monument at Camp Geiger Circle. This ceremony is set for 5 p.m., and those attending should use the entrance to the Marine Corps Air Station to access the site. Signs and sentries will direct you to the site. Earlier this morning, there was a candlelight vigil at this site for the families and survivors of the Beirut families. For the past 2 days, members of the 1st Battalion, 8th Marines, ran 241 miles in teams to honor those from Camp Lejeune who died. Let us take this moment. Thank you. Hurrah. Let us take this moment to thank the USO and the many volunteers that supported that event. Mayor Sammy Phillips continues the tradition of carrying the torch of remembrance and the commitment to our military families and our community to never forget the sacrifices of military families and their service members. A native of Jacksonville, a graduate of North Carolina Wesleyan College, East Carolina University, and the FBI Academy, Mayor Sammy Phillips served on the city council after retiring as the deputy police chief. In 2007, he was the first person ever elected mayor of Jacksonville for a four-year term. Today, Sammy Phillips continues the solemn pledge of this community to never forget the events of this day almost four decades ago. Please welcome Jacksonville Mayor Sammy Phillips.
On behalf of this caring community, my fellow council members and our city staff, and the citizens of Jacksonville, I welcome all of you that are in attendance today that have joined us, and including members of our armed forces, in particular, our Marines and sailors, also our community leaders, the Beirut veterans, all other veterans, and most importantly, the families of our armed forces, in particular, those that gave the ultimate sacrifice on this day 39 years ago. I welcome our beloved general, Al Gray, sits behind me. The 29th Commandant of the Marine Corps. And he heard me say the general's name. That's his dog. He's excited. He was the 29th Commandant of the Marine Corps, who holds a special place in our hearts here in Jacksonville and in the history of our city and of our Marine Corps. I would also like to recognize and welcome the 2nd Marine Expeditionary Force Commander, Lieutenant General David Ottignon. He has commanded at every level and will honor us with the Beirut Memorial Address later in the program. I extend a warm welcome to the 1st Battalion, 8th Marine Regiment Commanding Officer, Lieutenant Colonel William Kerrigan, Operations Chief, Master Gunnery Sergeant Salvador Lopez. I also welcome our Commanding General, MCIE's Brigadier General Andrew Niebel, and our Commanding Officer, Marine Corps Air Station New River, Colonel Garth Burnett. It is here today where I am honored to renew the pledge that as a community and city, we will never forget October 23rd, 1983. We will forever be charged or changed as a result of the actions of that day. We mourn together the loss of life and grieve for their families and loved ones. We mourn together as a community, both military and civilian, as one community. So many were lost, and the loss touched so many, and through this tragedy, we created a bond, a reliance of faith and community and compassion of others, and a bond, a common bond of remembrance since 1983. We offer our compassion, our thoughts, and our prayers to the families of those whose names appear on the wall behind me. We honor them with this observance and our remembrance. While we mourn the great loss, we also honor the sacrifice that we are celebrating here today. We celebrate that we have worked together as a community to build a better place to live for all of us. We are a caring community as reflected in the city's seal, and it is with this spirit that we built the Beirut Memorial, and with this spirit that we continue to remember. 39 years ago tomorrow, classes led by Ms. Martha Warren at Northwoods Park Junior High School began funding efforts to plant a tree for each of those who died in Beirut. Today, students from Northwoods Park carry that same sentiment. They continue to come together to make yellow ribbons and place one for each tree planted at the Beirut Memorial Grove across from Camp Geiger. It's such an awesome sight. Ribbons are also placed by members of the community at businesses and homes and by members of the Oslo Civic Affairs Committee and the Jacksonville Environmental and Appearance Advisory Committee. And we thank all those who have participated and continue to participate in this heartfelt yellow ribbon effort. The yellow ribbons that you see out here today were also done by our students at Northwoods Park Junior High School. It's Northwoods Park Middle School now, but they made these yellow ribbons. You'll see them posted on the trees and all around, which I think was a wonderful gesture on their part, honoring our fallen. Exactly 36 years ago today, on October 23rd, 1986, this community gathered at this location to unveil this memorial. The memorial sets in stone this community's spirit to remember and symbolizes our resolve and our duty to never forget. The memorial has inspired others to be built here, and it is a testament that this community has advanced the spirit of caring. For Jacksonville, this is who we are. It is illustrated in how we continue to honor those who serve through our actions and good deeds that keep our community a great place to live. On behalf of the City Council in the city of Jacksonville. I want to give thanks to those who serve on the Beirut Memorial Advisory Board and others who have advanced this and other memorials as part of our duty to never forget. Together, we are all holders of a powerful pledge to never forget the service and the sacrifice of those whose names are etched on the wall behind me. Jacksonville will never forget to remember their contribution. Jacksonville will never forget the debt we owe to them for reminding us of the importance of a supportive civilian community, for a grateful, brave, and deserving military community. And Jacksonville will never forget the lesson their passing taught us, that we are not two communities, but rather one, military and civilian, whose lives are intertwined on a daily basis. Our commitment to you is to continue this spirit today, tomorrow, and forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Phillips. Thank you for your commitment to these families and to the city's continued commitment to never forget. Brigadier General Andrew Niebel is the Commanding General for Marine Corps Installations East, Marine Corps Base Camp Lejeune. He is someone who is familiar with our community, this being his fifth tour in Camp Lejeune, where before he served as the Chief of Staff for the 2nd Marine Logistics Group. He has served in the Marine Corps for 3 decades as a combat engineer and logistician. He holds degrees from the Amphibious Warfare School, Naval War College, and a Master's in National Security and Strategic Studies. Brigadier General Niebel embodies the current Make Ready campaign. He is part of this community and understands the unique relationship. Please welcome Brigadier General Niebel.
Thank you, Fernando, and it is really, truly an honor to be out here speaking with such distinguished guests. Not only do we have our former Commandant here, but we have most of the MEF leadership here and stories from all of you out there. As I've said in the past, it could fill the pages of a book. So thank you all. It's truly an honor for me to speak to such a distinguished crowd. And for those of you who know the Marine Corps, you know that honor is not a word that we use lightly. It's part of our ethos, honor, courage, and commitment. So it is my honor to be in your presence today to speak to all of you today. I'd like to thank the City of Jacksonville, Mayor Phillips, and especially the Beirut Memorial Advisory Board for allowing me to speak today and being part of this service today. But I especially want to thank all of the veterans that are out here today, all of those that were in Beirut, and all of those veterans that knew somebody that was in Beirut back in 1983. And most of all, I want to thank the families that are here today that had somebody that did not come home. Thank you for coming out, whether you're watching this in person here or whether you're streaming it. As you know, it was 39 years ago. 39 years ago, I was a junior in high school. I knew I wanted to serve. I knew I wanted to be a Marine back then. My dad was a Marine. He was part of 2nd Battalion, 4th Marines, Magnificent Bastards, and he would tell us stories. He would tell us stories when we were little about his time in Vietnam and Chu Lai. How he'd go out on ambush patrols or security patrols. And of course, we were younger, so we'd ask questions like, hey, Dad, did you ever shoot anybody? Did you ever see anybody get shot? And he would get a little bit somber then. He didn't mind talking about some of his stories, but he would get somber, especially when we talked about the Marines that were hurt. To me, at the time, it sounded like a big adventure, almost like a movie, something I wanted to go be part of. I want to get out there and do that. So I joined the Marine Corps, obviously, and it wasn't until I went to Iraq and Afghanistan that I really started understanding what service and sacrifice meant at a different level. There certainly was no adventure in a Marine dying. And there certainly, it certainly wasn't like anything you see in a movie. There's only duty and honor in serving our country's most noble profession. And that's protecting our way of life and the freedoms that we enjoy today as Americans. When you're close to somebody who has paid the ultimate price, or close to a family member, especially, or are a family member, you understand what this bond is that Mayor Phillips was talking about. The bond transcends time. Whether you're part of the greatest generation in World War II, fought in Korea, Vietnam, Beirut, it doesn't matter. When you've experienced sacrifice and know somebody who has paid the ultimate price, you're part of a special family. A family that only those of you who have been through it can truly understand. The bond isn't only between people, it's also between communities. As Fernando said, this is my fifth time stationed here at Camp Lejeune. And every time I come back, I either have a greater appreciation or that bond just keeps getting stronger. Over 70% of our families are out in the community. Think about that back in 1983, it was the same way. That community was the Marines in the city of Jacksonville in Onslow County. We are mutually dependent on each other. And Beirut forged a relationship and a bond that will never be broken. So today, we honor those who have paid the ultimate price. We honor their legacy, but we also damn sure should be celebrating their legacy. We have to honor those who have gone before us and celebrate them because they have paid the ultimate price for the freedoms that we enjoy today. We'll never forget them. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you and Semper Fi. Bye.
Thank you, General Niebel. Now we welcome a Marine veteran who was in Beirut following the Beirut bombing in 1983. He was with 2nd Combat Engineer Battalion at Camp Lejeune, and after serving in the Marine Corps, he served his country as a civil servant with the Department of Corrections in Pennsylvania. He is the current president of the Beirut Veterans of America. Please welcome Myron Kyle.
The title is a U.S. Marine, a U.S. service member. The title of a peacekeeper makes you into a peacemaker. The first thing a peacemaker must do is commit. Peacemaking is not being nice. Peacemaking may be kind, but is not passive. It demands a peacemaker steps into conflict. Peacemakers from biblical days would step between two warring parties. The peacemaker initiates reconciliation when others have wronged them. The peacemaker is quick to repent when they have wronged others. In a world where we have been disciplined to avoid conflict, peacemaking takes a commitment to move towards it. The peacemaker knows there is no peace without healing, and there is no healing without tough conversations and work. Today, and since 1986, we gather at this memorial to have those tough conversations and to work towards healing. The work is ongoing, like the healing process. You cannot heal alone. So through hard work across this great nation and across the world, there are memorials and exhibits in places. Places like the Alabama Veterans Museum in Athens, Alabama, Fort Jackson in Columbia, South Carolina, at the Chaplaincy Center, at the Marine Corps Museum in Quantico. Memorials and services are conducted in places like Princeton, West Virginia, Penn's Landing in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Hackensack, New Jersey, Moorestown, New Jersey, Mentor, Ohio, Fort Snelling National Cemetery in Minnesota, Litchfield in Danbury, Connecticut, Providence, Rhode Island. Haifa, Israel has 241 olive trees planted. Ceremonies are conducted at the Beirut, Lebanon American Embassy. At Arlington National Cemetery, where a Cedar of Lebanon tree stands with a memorial stone that reads, "Let peace take root." As we attend these memorials and through the tough conversations, may we find peace. Peace that may take root as we do the working forward with the words, "They came in peace," and that the first duty is to remember. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Myron. As we reflect on this awesome site, we want to thank the city, the base personnel who maintain it, as well as all the citizens and veterans who volunteer their time and money. Performing now is the Northside High School Chorus, who has graciously agreed to join the Observance today to perform their rendition of the song "For an Unsung Hero." The chorus is under the direction of Kyla Cooney.
Sing for unsung heroes, those who lay their dreams aside, choosing honor more than glory, pledging faith with quiet pride. Those whose uniform is courage, yet are unashamed of tears, finding in their love of freedom power stronger than their fears. Sing a song for unsung heroes, sing from sea to shining sea, as the faithful sang before you, sing the song of liberty. Let us sing for unsung heroes, those who answer freedom's call, those united by one purpose, all for one and one for all. We will sing and not be silenced, we will keep our voices strong, for as long as we keep singing, freedom's cry will still live on. Sing a song for unsung heroes, sing from sea to shining sea, as the faithful sang before you, sing the song of liberty. Song of liberty. My country 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrims bright, from
thank you, Northside High School Chorus. It is now my pleasure to introduce the Commanding General of the 2nd Marine Expeditionary Force, Lieutenant General David A. Ottignon, who will deliver the annual Beirut Memorial Address. This is a tradition to reflect on the sacrifices of those names behind me. Today, Lieutenant General Ottignon continues that tradition. He comes to this position of leadership after a career that included serving as a combat engineer, military assistant to the Secretary of the Navy, Inspector General of the Marine Corps, and as a commanding officer at all levels. He has participated in peacekeeping missions, insurgencies, and combat operations to protect our country and our freedom. Lieutenant General Ottignon has strong connections to our community, having served in the 2nd Marine Division. He truly recognizes the importance of this moment in history. Please welcome the Commanding General of the 2nd Marine Expeditionary Force, Lieutenant General Ottignon.
Good afternoon, everybody. It is a tremendous honor to be here with you this afternoon. And let me just begin with just some welcoming remarks. But first, I don't know about you, but I really thought that was very beautiful and really something. I'm probably going to get hit right now by the Commandant, but I do, sir, need to send my regards to you, sir. It's great to see you. Just wonderful that you're here, sir. It's an honor to have you here. And let me also just extend a warm welcome to all the families that are here of the fallen. It really is remarkable to have you here. It's not that you're ever gone, but an occasion to get us all together. It's a warm reminder of what family is, and I'm so grateful that you're here. Mr. Mayor, thank you for the opportunity. It's great to see you again as well. On behalf of the Commandant of the Marine Corps, your support, the community support for your Marines and sailors that are stationed here is very, very strong. It's really a privilege to come back to Jacksonville. Thank you. Let me also just briefly thank the city as well as the Beirut Advisory here for hosting this event. And I think we should recognize that these don't happen overnight. And I'd maybe if you would join me in applause for all those Marines and police officers, first responders. All the folks that put this together, thank you. Clearly, we're here to reflect and celebrate those Marines and sailors and soldiers that sacrificed their lives nearly 39 years ago today in the defense of our country. And I think an afternoon like this for me is just a reminder of just how strong the bond is when you say the word Marine. And what it means for us in the city and the city of Jacksonville when you say Camp Lejeune. And we gather as a community today and we do remember 220 Marines, 18 sailors, 3 soldiers that died on that fateful morning. Those men, those beautiful men, from the battalion landing team, 1st Battalion, 8th Marines, and the 24th Marine Amphibious Unit. They came in peace. We come this afternoon to make that commitment that we shall never forget. Each generation has their own moment in history. General Niebel describes where you were, where they can tell you exactly in a moment of history where they were, something like September 11th, 2001. For many Americans, that date is pretty significant. And I was reminded by my wife that There are many, many Marines in the 2nd Marine Expeditionary Force that hadn't been born yet from 2001. And the recollection of that is just our history. And the same can be said for 1983. But that said, countless of us, alongside families and of Marines and sailors who served in Lebanon, in Beirut, we remember. We remember. For me, I was an 18-year-old kid in college in upstate New York. I was a midshipman in the NROTC program. And I remember this day. And I distinctly remember the reactions of my cadre and my instructors. I understood the significance of the loss, but it would be several years for me to fully understand and grasp the significance of what had occurred and the trajectory that it had placed this country upon. You know, far from upstate New York, the men of 1-8 in the 24th MAU, they were on a peacekeeping mission. Among them was a 19-year-old named Lex Trahan. He was an only child from Lafayette, Louisiana. He had dreams of going to college. He wanted to be an engineer on an oil rig. On his journey, he decided to join the Marine Corps. He became a combat engineer. And at the age of 19, he checked into 2nd Combat Engineer Battalion, 2nd Marine Division. And he was one of the Marines that was killed that day. After his death, his mom, Shirley, never again made his favorite meal, the one that she served him before he shipped out, spaghetti and meatballs. Or John McCall, originally from New Jersey, where his family immigrated from Scotland, and he grew up in Rochester, New York. He graduated from Greece Arcadia High School, played football, loved cars, had an older brother and a younger sister. And if you listen to his friends and what was recounted, was he was pretty gung-ho, wanted to be a Marine. He and his buddy Paul would go down to the recruiter's office. Probably not many of you had this happen to you, but there was a sign on the recruiting office that said, "I'll be back at 1500 hours. I paused when I read that and saw that, and I tried to picture that in my mind. But that being said, his friend Paul couldn't wait. Joined the Navy. Not John. John went into the Marines. 2 months after he graduated his MOS school, John became a wireman in 1st Battalion, 8th Marines at the age of 19. And John was critically wounded on the 23rd, and he succumbed to his wounds on the 25th. Generations of Marines drive past this memorial every day, and they know the stories of 1-8 and the 24th MAU. And ironically, it was this same battalion landing team, except this time with the 24th Marine Expeditionary Unit, responded to crisis in Afghanistan. They were the first on the scene, and they participated in one of the largest non-combatant evacuations since the fall of the Berlin airlift. And they too, unfortunately, suffered tragic loss. And many of you were here with us as we held a candlelight vigil for them in August, right here in this park. You see, the Marine Corps is a unique and an elite fighting force. Many of you know that, you've served. We are inextricably linked to the principles that we defend of this great country. And when our nation calls, we answer every time. And without delay. We remain the force of choice for every combatant commander in crisis. And as it has been over our history, we continue to adapt, modernize, equip, and prepare for the future fight. Just this past year, 2nd MEF participated in exercises in Norway, demonstrating some of the flexibility of forward presence, a stand-in force, if you will, capable of conducting expeditionary advanced base operations. And on the same day that Russia invaded Ukraine, Marines were on the watch in Norway and rapidly transitioned to crisis by supporting the combatant command with F-18s and command and control systems to shore up the eastern flank in Poland. Nearly simultaneously, the 2nd Marine Expeditionary Brigade transformed itself into Task Force 61-2, joined the 6th Fleet out of Naples, Italy, and commanded naval and marine forces. The 22nd MEU, a part of Task Force 61-2, went up into the Baltics, first time in 20 years. Cold, really cold. But they were on patrol in the North Sea, in the Baltic Sea, assuring our allies, showing the might of the United States as a credible combat force, United States Marines aboard an amphibious ship. Many of you know this. As a Marine, you're taught your history. And it starts at boot camp or officers' candidate school, but you're taught your history. And you're reminded of traditions passed down. You're reminded of the fighting spirit. And you're reminded of the sacrifices of those that have gone before you. You are keenly made aware that you stand on the shoulders of giants with an awesome responsibility to uphold the success of the Corps. And so today, we're all reminded, that we stand on the shoulders of these brave men, men like Lex and John, and we remember. We remember all that ran to the sound of the guns that morning. And we accept the responsibility to understand the meaning of their sacrifice and uphold their legacy. And on a day like today, we recommit ourselves to the core. We acknowledge that we are part of something bigger, something stronger, that binds us in this community, with our families, and with Marines and sailors. And today we remember the fighting men, Battalion Landing Team 1-8, and the 22nd MAU. And we want to tell their story. And we commit ourselves to never forget. And I can assure you, in 2MEF, we will never forget. Semper Fi.
Thank you, General Ottignon. Today, we are honored to have the 2nd Marine Division Band under the direction of Gunnery Sergeant Hector Munoz, Jr., continuing the tradition of performance and participation during this observance. Thank you. All right, thank you, Gunnery Sergeant Munoz and 2nd Marine Division Band. Any short introduction of the 29th Commandant is inadequate to describe the influence, appreciation, and dedicated service of General Al Gray. General Al.
I know we've all been waiting for that because it's sort of near the end now, right? Thank you. I want to also express my sincere thanks to really to everybody, to the great town of Jacksonville and its mayor and all, to the Beirut Committee, to all of the people who have helped us keep our dream alive. We said in 1983, when we gathered together, despite the heartbreak, the sentiment, the feelings, the sadness, losing our fallen warriors and the despair of the families and all of that, but we did say one thing. We said that we would never forget our Beirut Memorial people, and we would never forget what happened, and we would always remember those great fallen heroes who were simply trying to keep the peace and serve our great country and serve it well. And when we look at the surroundings here with our beautiful Beirut Memorial, with the Vietnam Memorial, the additional monument to the fallen corpsmen and the like in the Montford Point Marine area, and I should say for those of you who may not know from out of town and the like, way back here, we're soon to have a Marine Corps Museum. And that Marine Corps Museum is really can be credited to a tremendous amount of work by a great many people. Not the least of which, of course, are the representatives, the congressmen and senators and the like from this area. But the people of Jacksonville, the people of Eastern Onslow County, the people from the great state of North Carolina are making all of this happen. And our 1st Battalion, 8th Marines will have a significant part in the museum and the story behind it, and what it means to all of us. So it's a great privilege to be here with you again, to see so many of the families and the loved ones, and watching all the kids grow up and get married and the like. And by God, believe it or not, there's a smile on almost everybody's face. So that's good. Glad to see that you're doing well. Keep it up, and the only really request I have for all of you is the one I always make. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. God bless you, and Semper Fidelis.
Thank you, General Gray. Every year during our observance, it is our custom to lay memorial wreaths at the Beirut Memorial Wall. Doing so today symbolizes this community's lasting memory and appreciation for those who passed, as well as our continuing appreciation for their families and loved ones. The first wreath presented today is to honor the unique connection of the military and civilian communities in Jacksonville. Jacksonville Mayor Sammy Phillips and Lieutenant General Ottignon will present this wreath on behalf of our caring community. The second wreath presented is to honor those who lost their lives in Beirut and Grenada. The commanding officer, Lieutenant Colonel William Kerrigan, and the operations chief, Master Gunnery Sergeant Salvador Lopez, of 1st Battalion, 8th Marines, will present this wreath on their behalf. The third wreath presented is to honor the memory of our local Marines and sailors who have been killed in accidents while training for our defense. Brigadier General Niebel, Commanding General, Marine Corps Installations East, Marine Corps Base, Camp Lejeune, and Colonel Garth Burnett, Commanding Officer of the Marine Corps Air Station New River, will present this wreath on their behalf. Also, let's remember the 58 French peacekeepers who died on this day 39 years ago. Please rise for these honors. Please remain standing for the retirement of the colors and the benediction by Lieutenant Derek Vandenslunt, Chaplain, 1st Battalion, 8th Marines. Then remain standing for the service songs. This year will include the U.S. Space Force anthem, which was released last month. Retire the colors. Thank you.
I've been inspired in the reading of the stories of the chaplains and many of the families of the Beirut Remembrance. And I celebrate and honor and thank you all for sharing that time of healing with one another, because it's in telling our stories and in welcoming and encouraging one another that healing takes place. The motto, "They came in peace," is one of the things I picked up on very quickly. Jesus spoke in John 14:27, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid." Let us pray. Lord God, we give you thanks for this day and this time that we can gather, for these Marines that gather on our right and our left, for the ability to remember and to honor and celebrate and even catch a glimpse of inspiration from those who have gone before us, from those who have given their lives. We celebrate them, we treasure them in our hearts, and we reach out and support one another. Support and ask for your blessing on the families of the fallen and the wounded who are still healing. We ask for your grace. We ask for those who can't be here today, who maybe are reaching out and watching this online, that you'd reach out and connect to them as well through the power of your Spirit. Enable us, as we remember, to continue to connect with one another, to remember the Marines that are in zones of danger, and to keep them in our prayers. We pray that you help us as we live our lives, that we may continue to be agents of peace. We pray for those who are traveling, that you would bless their travels as they return after the celebration is done. And we ask for your guidance each day of our lives. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us stand together in silent remembrance and give honor to the families while they move to the memorial area. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending. This observance has now concluded, but our duty to remember continues. Thank you.